This is cool.
It's kind of funny. Like, there's a spire, so maybe he's going overlord hunting or something. Like,
look at this.
Even if he had mutas, he'd kill him with these liberators.
Look at this.
Wow.
Wow.
How do you clear that? Like,
what do you
have
do?
To go corrupt.
Oh, my God. Look at the queen. Does she fit in there?
What?
What? She can't get hit in
oh
that?
Oh, my God.
Oh. Uh-oh.
Party's that was... over.
That queen was awesome, though.
I know.
Oh, my God.
That was crazy.
I feel like that queen should enter, like, a limbo contest or something on, like, a cruise boat. Oh, he missed the Crosa Biles right there. Very painful.
In fact, having a hard time. Yeah, that queen was like a contortionist or something, how she fit back in that corner
and wasn't
able to be hit. I've said this before, but I feel like sometimes we cast games that are like epic battles, and other times it's like watching a lion eat a gazelle.
Yeah.
So I feel kind of like this is one of these games where it's a lion eating a gazelle, because we're kind of just seeing Impact slowly get taken apart here. These attacks...
Is it a lion eating a gazelle, or is it, you know, buffaloes that are, like, trying to get over a river and a crocodile has grabbed one and has pulled it underwater? Because both games he's losing, like, 12 drones to the very first Hellions that come in, and then the Liberators come and wreck things, and it's just like, everything going wrong.
Yeah, a bumpy start here for Impact, man. Really, really bumpy start. Again, if he loses this, he's not eliminated yet. But, I mean, it's kind of a bad sign. It's not so much important that he's eliminated is how we're seeing how he's playing in these games, which seem to be not up to par, at least compared to TY.
No, certainly not. Look at this. A two medevac drop here with a bunch of Stim Marines. Doesn't really get that much done, but he keeps trying.
Oh,
he keeps looking
God.
For it. Oh, tasteless.
Oh, Artosis. Oh. This is – so, oh, my God. Is he going to get another shot off on this?
Oh, God. Are you kidding me here?
No.
Look at all those carcasses.
Oh my God.
Jeez.
It's like, that's sad. This is actually.
This is like a gazelle getting hit by a nuclear bomb.
This is pretty brutal. And he's going to continue to stim in here. Watch, he actually gets the hatchery this time, too. He's like, no, this worked last time. It's fine.
Like, well, Banshees didn't get that down almost all the way.
A lot of people are killing the workers, but I found out if you kill that building where they return the money to, it's also good. So I think big here.
Man, TY is just, like, so far ahead, it doesn't even make sense here. Look at the army supplies right now, 36 to 77 with Terran in the lead, and you're on Roach Tech. Wow.
Well, I can tell you, dare I say I am the Oracle, and I can see the future.
I feel like...
Do you guys want to... I'm actually from the future. That's 5 minutes from now.
Yeah.
Okay, I time travel back here. Terran's going to move out and kill Zerg.
Oh, wow.
With a bunch of Terran units.
I think that's a pretty good call.
Yeah. Look at me. I'm Tasis from the past. 5 minutes before where we were here. He lost too many workers back there. There's no way he's going to be stable in the late game.
Wow.
And
we
here
could make
I
a movie
am, Tasis of the present. Okay.
I have so many Tasises up here, guys. It's just wild.
Yeah. Okay, here we go.
Look at that. One was already too many.
Look at that.
So.
I called it, man. I'm the Miss Cleo of esports. We got this push coming out here. And
I think with this push coming out and he sees it, this is where Impact should just close his eyes and wait for this to be over. Like,
this is brutal.
Like, and you're waiting for the monsters to go away.
You know what Zerg's thinking, too. Zerg sees this, and Zerg's like, oh, God. He's, like, making a step back and all.
Yeah.
He's like, this is going to be bad. Nice. I got to try.
He's trying to pop out some infestors. Oh, God. Liberator's going to town on him. Oh.
Man, oh, man. Now, note, TY actually proceeding with a little bit of caution here. He's not just 1A in this. But he is getting closer and closer to actually coming in here. Oh, man, and Impact's not even able to mine from about half of his mineral patches back there because the Liberators are hitting so hard in his...
Even if he could mine, he couldn't make enough units to hold this. Like, everything in the whole universe is wrong for Impact right now. But you know what? He doesn't need to, like, necessarily leave the game right this second. It's good to get your hands kind of warmed up. He's going to have to really try hard in his next match against the Protoss, though.
All right, he's stimming up here. I think we'll probably see Impact punt. Yeah, there it is. GG. GG.
Wow.
2-0 to start tonight off. A very one-sided match.
That was a slaughtering for sure.
But you know what? I could make lemonade out of these lemons, Artie.
Yeah.
That is how good TY is. He might be going to the finals again this season. He looked really good.
No,
Impact is a solid player.
He looked ridiculously strong, and that's what we expect out of TY, and he's definitely one of these favorites to make it really far. Like, maybe the finals, maybe win. Maybe he'll win BlizzCon this year. He is of that level where we cannot count anything out for TY as a possibility. Whereas Impact, He's getting really strong, guys. But tonight, so far, this doesn't look any good. Like, he had a very tough time.
Yeah, unfortunately. Well, I mean, he might still get out. But after seeing that today, I'm actually thinking.
You better hope T.Y. gets out in first place if he wants to have any chance.
Yeah.
If, like, SOS or Super takes out T.Y. in that winner's match, man, Impact it may as well go get in the SK van and go home. Like,
by the way, can I point out, we were talking about this earlier, we have exactly one hot six can here.
Who's going to drink
it? Didn't we have six here before?
Yeah, we did.
Are they trying to pin us against each other? Is that what's going on here?
Well, that would make great TV, and I'm sure Hot Six would really enjoy watching us fight over one can. That would be, like, a great commercial
company's
for
like,
them.
It's great. We got these two white guys to fight each other to the death.
What they don't understand is that anyone that comes to the studio gets it for free at the front desk.
Yeah, that's true. Well, we don't normally get it. We just got them up here. Anyways, we are going to be back in just a little bit with our second best of three in tonight's GSL Code S. 맑고 깨끗한 칠성사이다.
아, 짬뽕이네.
와, 맛있는 거.
근데 어디서 시킨 거예요? 그거 시킨 거 아닌데. 오뚜기 볶음 진짬뽕인데. 오뚜기 볶음 진짬뽕. 볶음 뜬 짬뽕. 볶음 뜬 짬뽕.
와, 정말로 화끈하네.
볶음 진짬뽕 외에는 절대 현혹되지 마소.
나는 KT 기가 인터넷. 당신과 끊김없이 게임을 즐기죠. 어디서나 우린 함께해요. 어때요? 나랑 콜라보 하실래요? 당신의 KT.
이거 좋은데?
답답할 때 마셔봐요 트로피카나 상큼상큼 과일 듬뿍 스파클링
리얼 프루트를 스파클링으로
과즙이 톡톡 쏜다
트로피카나 스파클링
대신 좀 혁신
이런 실시간 라이브 움짤 기능은 지금 스노우웹에서밖에 없죠. 굉장히 많은 팬분들이 영상 메시지와 메신저를 보내주고 계십니다. 아프리카 원탑 역캠답게 이설이라고 메시지가 왔는데 길 가다 만나지 마라. 길 가다 만나지 마라고. 느낌 있죠? 리본 하나 찬 다음에 딸랑딸랑 고양이 섹시합니다. 외쳐 스노우 헬라마.
스타일? 상쾌하면 되는 거야. 상쾌함의 높이가 다르다. Stylish Sparkling Water, Lotte Trevi.
네, 아프리카 TV와 함께하는 킹덤 스토리 연애의 신.
이거 사극을 찍는 것 같아요.
정말 안 어울립니다. 약간 애소하고.
위초고 삼국 대결.
장비.
나 심쿵했어.
17,800. 와.
분지는 무릎을 꿇을 수 있어요.
아 뭐야 이거 어떻게 본 건데?
저에게는 간호 장비 같은 존재입니다. 진짜 유익한 게임이니까 여러분들 진짜로 많이 해보셨으면 좋겠습니다.
모바일 게임을 넘어선 액션 RPG 히트.
양 팀이 이제 정해졌는데
그냥 대결하면 좀 재미가 없으니까요.
탈락.
이선을 향해 쐈어요.
에이 큐피트.
에이 큐피트야 뭐가.
이 정도라면 4분 때에 마무리 되나요? 자 이거 3대 1. 이게 들어가는데요. 유저 전체에게 깃털 1000개를 선물로 드립니다.
타이밍이 지금인 것 같습니다.
그만한 게임이 지금 모바일 게임에는 없다고.
더 힘찬 행사로.
오호 물로 지금 거의 뭐 수분을 그냥 갖다 들이붓는 것 같아요. 자 바른 쪽과 안 바른 쪽입니다. 차이 보여드릴게요. 내가 발라봤는데 대편. 앞으로 그냥 나도 찍어 발라야 될 것 같아요. 잘 봐요. 자 이렇게 깔끔하게 아래쪽만 다듬어도 선이 딱 살아있잖아요. 선 라인 같아요. 잠깐만. 오 이런 느낌이구나. 허허. 오늘 여러 가지 제품들 올리브영에서 제가 지금 제품을 받아서 사용을 해봤는데 굉장히 좋은 것 같아요. 올리브영 제품이 짱인 것 같습니다.
올리브영 플러스 유소나 예뻐져라 뷰티 방송 홈쇼핑 아닙니다 첫 뷰티 방송 시작하겠습니다 달콤한 꽃에 겹겹이 둘러싸인 듯 아 여러분 이 모든 제품들은 올리브영에서 살 수 있습니다 새로운 네일 아트로 사랑을 표현할게요 감사합니다. 고맙습니다. 세상에.
스타일? 상쾌하면 되는 거야. 상쾌함의 높이가 다르다. Stylish Sparkling Water. 롯데 트레비.
나는 KT 기가 인터넷 당신과 방송국을 만들죠. 어디서나 우린 함께해요.
어때요? 나랑 콜라보 하실래요?
당신의 KT.
우리 올리브 영에서 드디어 루이저를 변화시키기 위해 아프리카와 함께 루이저 변화시키기 기대장성이 들어갔어요. 이게 스타일 업무 제품입니다. 어, 피부 밝아지는 것 같은데? 와, 이런 게 올리브영 클라스구나. 라마? 라마? 라마띠. 와우! 영국 스타일. 네, 멋있네. 나가면 번호 따일 것 같은데? 여기서 마무리할게요. 우리 제품은 올리브영 제품이었습니다.
미소가 생기다. 화사함이 생기다. 건강한 하루가 생기다. pH 8.0과 풍부한 미네랄로 핑크빛 생기가 생기다. 아이시스 8.0. 이제 모두 핑크하세요.
2016 Hot 6 GSL Season 2 Code S. GSL Code S, bitches.
Oh, Jesus.
That's right. That's how they know I'm hard, Dan.
Yeah.
That's how they know I'm a hard dude. Using bad words.
Wow.
Cover the ears of the children.
The internet. Like, well, I think like the internet is where swears
they
were
can't
invented.
Stop me here. I'm safe on the internet, guys.
Oh my. We just saw a completely one-sided bopping TY destroying Impact.
It was quite a bop. If it was a meal, it would have been a beep and bop.
Wow.
Yep. Yep. Yep.
Yeah, if it was a bad toy from the 80s, it would be a bop it.
One, two, three. Wow. All right. This match coming up here is going to be good. SOS, the guy who seems to understand this game on some kind of Rain Man-like level.
Yeah.
Like, he just really, really gets it in ways that really behoove a Protoss player. He's got all these different builds. Now, Super is actually way on the up and up.
We've seen this guy. Which I never, ever expected. This guy is from the beginning of StarCraft II. He's always been mediocre, but right now he's really rising up. Like, the Afrika team in general is really rising up. And I'm not saying that because I'm employed by Afrika, guys. I'm not saying that because Mr. Che told me to or he'll fire me. You know, it's just, they really are. They're doing fantastically. They made it into, you know, the playoffs of Pro League recently. Super's a big part of that.
Yeah. It's kind of crazy. He's brought out the ace match a couple times. In Pro League, where my predictions are basically always wrong, by the way. I am, I'm always like, no, they're
the
not going to bring him out.
The Tasteless Curse, is that it?
That's what they're calling it, man. The Tasteless Curse. Well, we're going to start this out on the map, Frozen Temple. Map 2, King Sejong Station. Map 3, GSL Rockshear.
Okay, what do you think about this match? Who takes it?
I think it's SOS.
You think SOS just straight up takes it?
Yeah.
I think you're probably right, and I'm a little bit nervous for Super because he's been using the same build in the same location on this map over and over. Like, this is part of the reason why they lost.
This is the symptom of the style of play. Is he kind of does the same thing over and over?
Yeah.
We're like SOS, like, guys, if the aliens invade Earth and they need to compete against humans in StarCraft, they bring out SOS, okay?
Actually, I have some good stuff to say about that, but let's get into it first.
Countdown started, guys. Game number one, SOS versus Super. In the blue, over here, two-time world champion.
G Generic Green Wings. SOS.
One thumb up for each time you won.
Oh, what if he wins GSL and then wins BlizzCon again?
We got to get another arm and attach it to his body and gets it a third thumbs up. So,
Afrika Freeze.
Over here, Super.
And the thing is, like, I know SOS, he wouldn't use that third arm on the keyboard or anything for extra APM. I think what he would do is he'd be playing with his two arms and the other one would have a little, like, Jin Air flag that he's waving over his head.
Thanks for coming down, guys. Welcome to the studio.
Okay, so what you were saying about SOS.
Yeah.
And the fact that if aliens come, you should defend us. You haven't read Ender's Game yet, have you?
I did not read Ender's Game. Okay, everybody tells me this. People have been telling me this for, like, 15 years. They're like, that book is basically StarCraft. But I have not read it yet.
It's not as StarCraft as Starship Troopers, I would say, but it's really good. It's like, and the whole series is really good. I know you're reading Dune right now, but when you're done that,
well, here's the problem.
If I could suggest your next sci-fi book, definitely pick up Ender's
Game. I'm actually a little bit
because he's like kind of. That's kind of like what you were talking about.
I'm a little bit worried because I started reading the book Dune, but I actually ordered all the books at once. So I have 6 Dune books that are all, each one's like 1,000 pages.
Why did you order them all at once? That's like so daunting. I'd be like afraid to read the first one looking at the stacks of other ones.
Well, it was one of these situations where I was talking to my friend back in the States, and he was like, oh my God, this book is so, he was like talking about it for like 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And I was like starting to get like all hype. I'm like, oh, that sounds good. Because I had just finished reading American Gods. I'm like, all right, I need another 1,000 page book to sit around and grind on.
No, I know about that. I read a lot of really thick ones. They take a very long time.
These are our humble brags, guys. We're like, by the way, we play video games and read books. So we're hoping we leave you guys.
I don't think that's a brag. It's like, wow, these guys are some serious nerds. They're like reading science fiction books and playing a science fiction game.
Yeah.
Their lives are science fiction. I'm like, what are you even talking about, guy in the chat? You are so dumb.
So we got 2 adepts coming out here. For SOS.
Yeah, he's going up to 4 adepts, and he's like the only person that will make adepts nonstop. Like, I remember one game he had here where he ended up making like 8 or 10 adepts and just kept sacrificing them for probes and keeping his opponent back. It was like so wild and weird.
Yeah, this is the weird thing about SOS is he's not ever following a trend, ever. You know what I mean? He just kind of looks at a map. We had this game we saw, I believe it was on Pro League, where it was one of our new maps. And it was so different what he was doing. And he actually lost the game because he, like, slightly got into a bad position. Mm-hmm. But, like, the way he was looking at it, I was even saying in the cast, I'm like, yeah, that's SOS for you. You know, it's, like, the brand new map. He always has basically the best understanding on anything that's new.
Yeah.
And SOS, we never cast a game of his where we go, oh, he's doing that thing that everybody else is doing. He really does approach the game in his own way.
He does indeed, and Super is mixing this up quite a bit.
Oh my god!
Like,
cool.
I think Super is going to be able to take this taste.
Look at this!
Oh, I like
that
this
was actually
a lot.
Pretty smart.
He's like, 4 dips beat 2 stalkers.
Well, it's pretty smart because, like, yeah, he can send those back. He can actually catch that no matter what. By the way, we have a warp prism coming
and
out.
Yeah, this is 3 gates and a warp prism on 1 base against someone who's made like only adepts and expanded.
Yeah.
So the odds of that expansion staying up, pretty low. Pretty low, I would say.
I think you might be right. I think this is actually a great play here.
Yeah, he might go for the jugular too, though. Like, he might go right up into the main base and skip everything off.
Yeah, that's definitely an option as well. Okay, so this game could end very quickly. Super's actually just going to go for the kill, like right now.
That is a lot of stalkers. He does have that second pylon coming up. He's trying to get out an immortal right now to help out. The thing is, the prism is what's really going to wreck him. And, okay, so very nice micro. He is not even going to, you know, run away at all from these overcharges. He just wants to kill everything as quickly as possible. He has the upper hand.
Okay, so there is a timer here for Super. Super has to make this attack work. Looks like he wants to try to jump into the main, possibly. Okay, I gotta say, actually, I thought this was gonna do more damage than it is doing. Oh my God, is he gonna lose the Mothership Core? Well, we're not gonna look at that, apparently. Our observer moved the screen. Okay, he did.
That's pretty painful. He does have an immortal out, though, and he has cleaned up the adepts that were inside his base. So this is kind of being held so far.
Yeah,
now, I love this move by Super, though, the fact that he keeps shading up into the main base, because that makes SOS split his units up or he's going to lose all his probes.
Okay, well, he's going to have to commit to this fight over here. I don't believe, actually. Oh, good job there by Super. Ticks out the pylon right when Mothership Core pops out.
Dude, he has a second immortal now. This push is done.
Well, guys,
but what's the probe count at? Let's take a look. SOS. 28 probes against 24. Yeah, no, that is an unfathomable lead right now. That's crazy.
Okay, so guys, whenever you see these one base builds where they're hitting them hard, if they don't kill him,
yeah,
and you're at this level of play, the guy with two bases, if he holds it off, he's just gonna have more money, he's gonna win. So
yeah, having that base is such a gigantic deal now. He is trying to harass. Oh my god, if he were to lose that.
Oh my god, it's got 2 hit points,
Artosis. Oh my god, 2 hit points. If I had a dime for every 2 hit point shuttle. Well,
you would have $2.
Yeah.
This is bad, man. Oh, he's gonna go for the observer. Can he actually get it? Yes, he does.
Yeah, he's in such a good spot here. Now he kind of gets to choose how he wants to go about this. I like the fact that he's going into a twilight. He's not just gonna walk across the map and try to kill his opponent. That's where stuff could go wrong. But if he does something like just get blink way quicker than his opponent, how do you hold on against that?
I don't think you do. Oh no! How many lives does a Warp Prism have, Artosis? It's the second time this thing has escaped.
Yeah, well, it's got this funny thing called shields that just regen. Can you believe it?
What?
What?
Gotta get Blizzard on my speed dial, man.
Oh my gosh. And did you know probes can't repair it? But it doesn't cost any money to regen.
Is he gonna get this Warp Prism?
He might.
Is he actually gonna finally get it?
Oh my god.
Oh.
That's 4 Sockers in there.
Yeah. Good job by SOS. Actually hunted that down all the way across the map.
SOS has right now a CD player, and on that CD player, it just keeps saying BlizzCon, BlizzCon, BlizzCon,
BlizzCon.
BlizzCon.
BlizzCon. What's weird is SOS is not one of GSL.
I know, isn't that
weird,
guys?
Isn't
that bizarre? Well, GSLs don't really have enough prize money anymore. If he was playing back at the beginning, we might not even know.
Yeah, it's any tournament that's got a $100,000 prize, that's why I was like, oh, okay.
Yeah, he's won every $100,000 tournament he's been in.
6 figures, you said? I'll be right there. Yeah. And he starts making his cannons outside the guy's base.
He's like, wait, how many zeros is that? Like, oh, sick.
Oh, yeah, all right. Okay, so, I mean, this is kind of an easy road for SOS. From here on out,
mm-hmm.
You kind of just make stuff. You develop your tech, and make the proper amount of workers, and eventually you push out.
Yeah, it's really good because look, he's not really taking any risks here, right? He's got a very strong army right there.
Right.
He's gotten glaives, so that's getting very popular right now in the matchup, and he's taking the third base. So if he just sits here and starts making a whole bunch of adepts, to go Adept Immortal is a fantastic combo.
It is. A lot of damage coming out of that. Mm.
They just really complement each other in a lot of ways. So see this? Super's trying to get something done. He can't, though. There's nothing to get done here. He cannot break through.
This is actually a little bit of something.
Hmm.
A little something. Kill some workers. Gets about 3. He actually needs to kill more than 3, or these Adepts have not paid for themselves.
Yeah. Keeping him back, I guess, but did that actually shade out?
What?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Didn't do anything. There's something down there, though.
No.
Don't worry, Tasis. SOS didn't lose too many probes.
So
your favorite player is still going to win. Tasis is such a fan.
I know.
When I got down, we always meet up before the cast. He was just like, I really hope that SOS wins today.
It's going to be hard to cast
the game. I want him to be the 3-time BlizzCon champion.
I might just be cheering the whole time instead of casting.
And then Tasis was all like, Artosis, I think that he might be the best player ever not to win a GSL. What do you think about that? I'm like, yeah, maybe Tasis. I don't know.
GG. SOS handedly takes out Super. By the way, guys, if this is going to go the way it's looking, we have TY versus SOS coming up.
Wow.
How cool is that?
Yeah, no, that's an insane, insane game. As cool as a cucumber taste.
That's
how cool.
That's pretty cool. Whoa, when did this thing get here?
Yeah, no, someone gave us something to hide our 1 hot 6 scan.
Wow, okay.
Probably a lot of people were tweeting at a freak would be like, hey, listen, plebs, why do they only have 1 hot 6 scan? In fact, the Koreans don't have any hot 6 scans. I think there's a hot 6 shortage out here.
It's kind of we got the Hamburglar version of hot 6 scans.
Dude,
we got the Hamburglar of energy drinks. He's coming here. He's taking all of our energy drinks. We can't have a tournament without it.
This is serious.
Don't show that on camera. He's going to get those two.
This is Wow. I mean, move over California with your water drought. What about no hot six?
We're
it's
running
an issue.
Out of energy drinks out here.
Oh, my gosh. So, how do I stay awake?
Map number two is going to be on our classic map, King Sejong Station, SOS versus Super. Let's see if Super can turn this around. In the upper left, in the blue, he is...
Jin Air Green Wings, SOS.
BlizzCon.
I want the BlizzCon money. Activate Kill Super Build.
Afrika Freaks Super.
I think that what SOS should do, because this would be like really fun, is like, for instance, when he kills that warp prism that has four stalkers in it, he should just like yell. He should be like, BlizzCon, as he kills it. Like, anytime a big fight happens, or like if he loses like a bunch of probes suddenly to an adept attack, or like an oracle flies and kills a bunch of probes, he should go, BlizzCon. So he'd basically be like a Pokemon whose name was BlizzCon. It's like the only word he uses, but like he has like a big range with it, you know? He's like Groot or something like that.
Yeah. Are there, because I actually did not really play the Pokemon games.
Yeah.
I know I'm going to get crucified for saying this on Twitter. I didn't play the Pokemon games. I didn't really watch the cartoon.
Yeah.
But is
loser.
Yeah. I immediately get like, I lose my job. They're like, you're not a nerd. Get out of here. Like,
yeah.
But I read books.
Like, yeah, you probably don't even read books.
What is this, the 70s? Nerds all play
How many hoodies do you own, Tasteless?
Is Pikachu the only Pokemon that just says its name?
No.
They all say their names?
Yeah.
Wow.
Except
right.
Meowth. He taught himself how to talk.
Okay. Sorry, guys. I, like, just totally, like, shot myself in the foot here. People are like, ew.
God.
Who? Is there Artosis in that poser to cast this game?
Doesn't even know what he's talking about.
And I'm like, well, I'm a huge Star Wars fan, guys.
Like, you can't get back in with that. That's too ubiquitous. So, in this game, it's SOS now going. He's getting two stalkers now. And it is Super going for the double adepts here.
Yeah, that's a little bit of a switch up.
Mm-hmm.
Interested to see what he wants to do with those stalkers. Super, of course, going to be able to get a little bit more scouting intel because of making those adepts.
Artosis.
Yes.
What is his probe doing?
Hiding. Obviously.
Obviously.
Like, he's going to build a Nexus there. What do you think?
Oh, my
wow.
God.
Well, I guess that's probably going to be a Stargate, right?
I think so. He's hiding it right.
The only way that could be closer is if he made it in his opponent's mineral line.
That is like hiding right under Super's nose.
Yeah.
Actually, we've seen this like really rarely. People actually hide stuff down there. Look at this. This is like... It's like you can actually,
jeez.
It occupies the same screen. Like, look at that. That's like, I need to like get a ruler out. That's like a centimeter out of the
vision so
on a computer
well,
screen.
Well, that's why he puts it there, is because it's like, well, you're not going to check that extra like 1 millimeter. Like, close enough is good enough most of the time, except you're playing against SOS.
Well, here's what's funny about it. Like, think of how fast that Oracle is going to get there.
Very fast.
That Oracle's not even going to reach full acceleration from flying, okay?
Right before the Oracle finishes building, it'll start killing probes. That's how quickly it'll get there, Tasteless.
That's how quickly, man. Okay. Let's see where Super is defending, because this is just so fast. But what if it doesn't have enough energy to kill the probes because it gets there so fast? No, but seriously, that is like, that is so close.
Yeah.
Anyways, we're moments away from this attack starting. Now, it's actually not just that he's going to hit the workers in the main. He's going to set up and hit the front, too.
Yeah, the mothership core is way out of position right now, too.
The potential for damage here is huge.
Yeah, he's going to get a lot of probes because, look, this pressure he's showing here, the mothership core is supposed to be down there. Oh, my God.
Here we go. Here we go.
This is where Super's like, I guess I'm playing Impact.
He's actually not doing as much damage as I would have thought. He's also hitting up here in the front. Five.
Oh, this is, like, so good already. This is so good.
And he's already out of energy.
Oh, my God. Well, wow. He should have made it further away. He would have had more energy.
That's why you hide it in the bottom left corner of the map.
Yeah.
You get, like, five more seconds of damage.
I make my Oracle in game one, so when I attack him in game three, if I've made it that far, I can do two stasis warps, a tag, and kill 10 probes.
I love these jokes that we do where we...
we talk about like it, we get, it gets outside of the possibility of the game. When we were, I remember playing Street Fighter 4 in an arcade like 3 years ago, and you're like, Ken's uppercut is so good, I swear to God, sometimes he does it and it hits a player on a different arcade machine. It's
like yeah, it felt like that.
Yeah.
Okay, so that Proxy Oracle was just fantastic. I love this move as well. He's actually not microing perfectly here. Does mess up just slightly. Could have gotten a little bit more, but oh, that's a nice
bad.
Little move,
not
picking
bad.
Off a few units there for Super. But he's killed so many probes at this point. He's actually up 9 probes, and it's going to get even higher.
Yeah, he's about to kill, looks like at least 3 more right there.
Wow.
SOS. You devil, you. By the way, he still hasn't gone down there and actually found that Stargate's there. If Super goes out and attacks, I would make another Oracle.
Yeah, you may as well. This is a little bit scary. SOS is losing quite a few units to this little...
Now, did SOS overextend here? He might actually just die to this attack because he's been all over the place on the map.
That's a full Mothership core.
That's true.
He should be targeting... look at this. He's actually targeting that Immortal. He knows he has to kill that thing off. Once he kills that off, it becomes a lot easier to actually...
It's not dead. It's not dead. It's
you've
got
to be kidding me. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Did this game just get turned on
is
its head?
Is Super actually about to lose? Look at that. He lost a Mothership Core that still had 100 energy on it. Wow.
Okay, he needs to kill that in one Immortal, and it goes down. But is it enough? Already, he's doing so much damage. The Oracles are going to come in here.
Well, he's going to kill the Oracle, so that's going to feel good for Super as well. And now Super is actually ahead on probes.
Oh, my
Look
God.
That. Wow.
That game just got turned around so fast. That just... What?
The multitasking of SOS was definitely lacking slightly. Like, he lost way too many stalkers when he was harassing with his Oracle. And Super's like, well, I'm in terrible shape. I may as well go attack you.
Okay, so in case you guys are confused about what happened back there, SOS was doing everything right but was not... hyper-vigilant about his stalkers going back to his base in time.
Yeah.
And you need to have those. Even though it was just 3 stalkers, you actually have to have them.
Yeah, like if he had 3 more stalkers there, he actually will hold that. He would have still been in the game if he had not done that. And there were several times where Super was picking off extra units too. So, I mean, when they have an Immortal and you just have a few stalkers, you are going to get absolutely wrecked. You have to make sure you're out of there in time.
That means we're tied up 1-1. This is going to be the last game, at least for now. Super versus SOS. Super did it, man.
Yeah.
I thought SOS looked better, but we're not.
Well, not in the ways it counted.
Yeah, it doesn't really matter.
Nothing matters.
Nothing matters. The map is going to be GSL Rockshear. The winner has to go on and face off against TY in what is tonight's very difficult group, Group E. For this season 2 of
Group E, you said it.
Group E. E for esports. In the upper left, in the blue, he is.
Generic Green Wings.
I'm a groupie, groupie.
SOS.
BlizzCon, BlizzCon, BlizzCon. All the money in the world.
Thanks for coming down, guys. Welcome. Hope you're enjoying the games here.
Oh, you know they are.
Oh, you know they are.
If they weren't, they should leave.
Africa Freaks.
And that's not because I'm insulting you're not enjoying it, but like if you're not enjoying something, don't do it. What?
Yeah, exactly.
Life
is
way too short for that.
And we need to get crazy braced and be like, everybody's having fun, or else. So, let's see what happens with these two guys here. I think SOS. I mean, SOS is supposed to win this, right? That's what's supposed to happen.
He's supposed to. Like,
he's supposed
he definitely, if he hadn't been sloppy with those stalkers, like, if he had just sent his stalkers home, like, a few seconds earlier, he wins that game 100%. Because, like, that was, there was oracles on the map. The fact that Super left with all of his units to attack, that was, like, unbelievably all in. And if he hadn't caught that many stalkers, I think he actually killed 5 or 6 stalkers on the walk to SOS's base. That's a lot.
That's a lot.
No well, stalker left behind? I don't think so. Not for SOS that game.
We got, right now, there's not much we can do as far as speculating. We're still going to have to wait and kind of see what the tech is going to be. But I got to say, if SOS does win this, we're in like for such a great match. SOS TY
would just be so silly.
I actually do not know who would win with that.
And to be honest, Super Impact, I think, is a very nice match as well.
Yeah,
like they're
very
like
evenly
tuned for each other. Yeah, exactly.
Well, the feeling I get with Super at Impact is this very Dragon Ball Z-esque thing where they are getting more powerful.
It's like a couple Krillins fighting.
It's a couple Krillins, yeah. Got a couple Krillin nerds here.
It's Tien versus Yamcha. It's like totally sick.
Oh, look at this, Dan. We brought you a chair.
Yeah.
Now, nice. What you guys don't see on camera is I found this extra chair next to me, so I sit down and just basically
I was just squatting.
Stare at Dan. Yeah, but somebody just brought him a chair. That was very nice of them.
That's really
look
quick.
At that. Wow.
Look at this. All the people in the audience turn around and
I should have stopped.
Do you have a chair? I'm like, yeah, I have a chair.
What if we didn't? What
they're
if
like,
we?
Oh, that's funny.
But what if we didn't have chairs and we were lying? And
like, well,
were
you
like,
have a chair.
That's
I should
really
have a
weird.
Chair.
Like, why would they lie about that?
That would be so funny.
I'm like, hey, everybody, I have long pants on. And they look back like, he's wearing shorts. Why is he lying
that's
about
so
that?
Weird.
That's just a weird thing to do. That's just.
I'm like, Tasis, why are you shaving your beard during the cast? Everyone's like, he's not shaving his beard
like,
during the cast.
Don't they know he's going to be back on camera with a full beard? Can I tell you something that is so weird that happened to me a week ago?
No.
I was walking around. I was walking to go get my groceries. And this Korean man came up to me. He said, is your beard real? In English. He goes, is your beard real? And I'm like. Like, is this my facial hair? He's like, yeah. I'm like, yes. I'm thinking, like, are there people wearing fake beards? are there men with, like, Velcro? Yeah, that's what I was wondering. I'm like, no, I'm just a.
That's funny.
It was really weird. And he said, can I touch it?
Yeah? Did you let him?
Yeah. Well, I was like, yeah, sure.
Did he touch like it?
Yeah. And then he was like, and he goes, thank you. And then he walked away. And I was like, okay, strange encounters.
Huh.
And just so you guys know, in Korea, that's, like, totally not normal. Like, people normally don't interact with each other in the street as much. So that was pretty interesting.
Huh.
Anyways.
Maybe he's just a Tasteless fan, and, you know, that's, like, how he decided to approach. He's like, hey, is your beard real? It's like someone later on is going to walk up to me and say, Artosis, are those real shoes on your feet? And I'm like, well, define real shoes,
yeah, it's
right?
It's like, funny you asked that. Actually, I paint these on my bare feet. They're not real.
Oh, that's funny.
Okay, oh, so we have the we got SOS doing a lot of damage here with these adepts, by the way.
Yeah.
Good force field there. Got to be careful with these adepts. You can overextend with this. He's kind of forced to try to get the sentry.
Wow.
Looks like he just gets in that corner and have time to shade back out.
Five probes and a sentry for four adepts. This is like a funny thing. SOS does this more than anyone else. By the way, they're both getting glaives. This is really showing the shifts that we're seeing in this matchup, where like adept timing attacks are really, really strong, and obviously adept harassment is quite strong. So seeing more and more glaives, which is neat.
Going to be interesting to see how this last game goes out. It does seem like SOS just went for a little bit more of a cautious build. And I think this was the right move.
Hmm.
I think this was...
like SOS cautiously? Oh, because he's not like taking the third Nexus and stuff?
Yeah. Because I think that if you looked at the last game, like SOS was doing a good job, but he just made this one mistake, and it's like, oh, there you go. Hmm. You're out. There's this one little hole, you know? You can be all over the other player, but, you know, you're killing his workers. He's killing your army. So if he counters attacks, makes that work. So, and I think this is smart. I think a lot of times, like, if you guys... You know, never want to lose to somebody. Like, you know, like you get to your university, right? Trust me, this happens like all the time too. Or, you know, you're at your high school. You find out there's another nerd in your school who also plays. And you're like, oh, yeah, cool, man. Yeah, we should play. And you're like, oh, yeah, totally. Yeah. But you're thinking like, oh, no, I got to beat this guy.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not going to be the second best StarCraft player in my high school. No.
Oh, that would have been.
Not go for a cheese. You go for a long game because you're always probably going to win if you're better.
Just do something safe. If you're better at RTS, you want a longer game. It gives them more opportunities to mess up and gives you more opportunities to show your skill.
Yeah, so, exactly.
That's why we see like a lot of better players oftentimes play defensively if they're playing against weaker players. But conversely, sometimes it's really good to be very aggressive
because that's
true. Weak players, like, even if you're playing defensively, sometimes they're going to knock you out with something very aggressive. But if you're playing aggressive as well, a lot of players will fall apart against that because that's like more stressful to deal with than a macro play.
Oop. Just gets kind of gets the observer. Yeah, that is a good point. I've heard actually one thing that people recommend is if you think you're against an anxious player, like somebody who does have anxiety, just start attacking early.
Yeah.
No, just start poking because that can throw them off.
Yeah, that's that was like a common thing when we had some foreigners out here that played Pro League a few times. Like when State did his first one and stuff, like all the Koreans would just cheese them, the foreigners, as soon as they played their first games in Pro League and whatnot. There's
a lot of mind games going on to it, right? Because, cheesing is actually completely fine and oftentimes necessary to win a best of five or a best of seven. But it also...
Especially when you suck.
There's also an air of disrespect with it, too.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well, that's like a good way to upset
this
somebody.
This is why MVP might just basically still be the greatest StarCraft II player to have ever lived, was in that last game against Squirtle. This was like 4 or 5 years ago. Game 7, the most crucial game, he just double proxy Raxes him.
And it didn't look like he was going to work, and he made it. It was like so crazy. But anyways, we have Super doing a big attack here. He has +1 attack against no upgrade, so that's a kind of big deal. But look at this army of SOS, a very modern Protoss army with quite a few Adepts in here, as well as Immortals. These Stalkers are not going to be that useful. I feel like Super needs to run away here. When the Force Fields are gone, isn't he going to get wiped?
I think he, well, let's see. He's actually,
like, this army of SOS wins once the Force Fields are gone.
The Immortals are just too good here, right? But he apparently is just kind of committing to this.
Yeah, it's kind of kind of weird. And this was like, I mean, it's okay for him to attack right then, but he's about to have +2 attack, which is going to make his army even better, because SOS doesn't have upgrades.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
Think that Immortal's going to make it out, Tasteless?
I don't know. I don't think he's going to get away. No! Remember me. Maybe he got away. Maybe it's like Game of Thrones. I'm like, I didn't see him die on screen.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
And then later on, they say it. They're like, yeah, no, he's dead.
He's dead, yeah. Okay, the counterattack's happening by SOS. Now, SOS, I think this is a wise decision. He's actually going to rotate over to the other expansion. That's free pickings. SOS should not be taking risks in this.
Yeah. You know, he has such a better army, though. I think he can definitely poke in and do some stuff. Like, his Immortals are just too strong here. And he has, like, a similar number of Adepts. So how do you hold on against this? He's just, like, gaining so much value through this attack. He's going to easily be able to take that out.
Okay, we got another warp in happening right over here. I think that's kind of the beginning of the end here. Now, is he going to try to attack in here? I guess he can. I guess, you know what, with Adepts, I guess why not, right?
Yeah. You know, he doesn't want to walk into a choke and get wrecked or anything like that, so he's being a little bit careful. Oh, wow, a massive shade into the main base, and now he will shade out as well. SOS is just, he's playing great here.
Yeah, this is a really smart move. And look, he gets right back out. So much finesse. And SOS, you know, what's funny is this isn't, like, totally necessary, but it's like, you can do it. Now, unfortunately, these Stalkers are actually a pretty big nuisance, which is allowing Super to stay in this game.
Absolutely. Like, they're being heroes over there. They've killed the Mothership Core twice. They've killed a bunch of probes. He's doing a pretty good job with it. It's just, look at this. When you have to pull your probes up here, this is very, very rough.
Yeah. Now, he actually might have enough to take out this army. And by the way, the Immortals in this situation kind of can't run away.
Yeah, I mean, Adepts absolutely chase down Immortals.
This is something I don't know if we highlight enough, but there are some units that if you're in a fight, you got to run away. They will die.
Yeah.
They do not get out of there. Like Ravagers in some cases are like this against Protoss. It's like you can't run away from Protoss with Ravagers. They just blink on top of it every time. So maybe an overextension here by SOS. Look at this. It's like, I was going to say double dragon because they had their guns pointed in opposite directions.
And this Stalker harassment just continues onward. This is like never-ending 4 Stalkers in a Prism. SOS is like warping in 3 Stalkers to fight him. Like, I'm pretty sure 4 plus a Prism is better than 3. Oh, yeah, they have +2 attack as well, the 4 in the Prism. Like, SOS, man, I just don't know.
Okay, you know, as great as SOS has played, I actually am a little bit surprised he allowed the Stalkers to do that much damage back there.
Yeah.
If he did a little bit of a better job, you know what? Is there a glitch in the Matrix? Because this is starting to look a little bit like the end of game 2 here.
All he has to do is hold on to his natural, because he's only got 9 probes.
That's true.
That's like 9 probes. That's
I
not
just
even
wanted
10
to make
probes,
a Matrix
Tasteless. That's like,
I just, you know.
Well, this is Matrix 2.
I was trying to
He's not winning this one.
I was trying to get to the point where I make that joke, because, like, even though The Matrix is a great movie, there's that one scene where she's like, not like this.
Oh, yeah.
I was about to try to set that up, but it's okay.
No, that's that was a good moment.
This is going to be a safe space for comedy, okay? Everything I say is going to at least be kind of funny. Yeah. Super is really in a tough spot. You know, 3 times the number of workers here for SOS. But he's going to try to bust through here. And if he does bust through, and it is 2 Immortals to 1. Actually, 3 Immortals to 1.
Hey,
he can
gonna
do it.
He's going to shade right on top.
He might actually be able to do this. We'll see.
He's going to take down that sentry. That's adding a lot of defense here.
Yeah.
And, looks like it will finally be picked off. His Immortals being kept back pretty darn far here. He's got a micro a bit better with his Prism.
Oh,
he's letting his
God.
Stalkers die.
Hold on. It's really up to these 3 Immortals.
Yeah, I don't know if that's
going to be enough,
though.
There's too much. But actually, that was actually kind of close.
Yeah, Super made that a lot closer than it should have been.
Yeah, good job there. All right, sick. We're gonna have SOS against TY. Oh, I'm so excited.
Yeah. That was a good series, though. I like that. That was kind of interesting at the end there. But I think Super is overcommitting and like his, like he's playing almost completely modern in PvP. Modern as in this week's meta.
Yes.
Like of many, many more adepts we've seen each week. Protoss players experimenting with more of them and different unit comps. But like you see, SOS is like really, he's the point on the tip of the spear or something like that with that, right?
Okay.
Like he's sitting there. He doesn't even have a single stalker. He's making adepts all game. He's getting into immortals. He has a higher immortal count. So it's like, well, you made how many stalkers? And I have, like, that many immortals, you're kind of screwed.
Can I point something out?
Yeah.
This was not here before, and I never
you
saw
no
them
proof.
Put it here.
And
I
actually, our table is not quite high enough, too. Here, help me lift this.
Lift this up. All right,
there
so
we
see
go.
There's, it's
okay,
on our table.
So, yeah, so no, this has been very good.
We were casting that, and I turned around to get my water, and I was like,
you're not going
to
help me anymore? This is heavy. I'm like, oh,
I got to spot you. No, we were casting. Look, we oftentimes look up that screen back there, and I turn around to get my drink, and I'm like, whoa. What happened? Did the sign shade in here? I don't know.
Hot 6 scan is still there, don't you worry.
Yep. I was going to make a joke about how my action figures are lined up here. I put all my army men like right here, and now you guys can't see it. So we are going to go to a short break. We come back.
This is the Battle of the Bulge. I'm like, Tasis, I don't think it is.
Look,
I don't
guys,
know
I put all my toy trains in the desk, and they ruined it with this goddamn sign here, right? Too much branding. We're going to go to a short break. When we come back, it's going to be SOS against TY for the winner's match of tonight's GSL Code S.
KT 기가 인터넷. 당신과 끊김없이 게임을 즐기죠. 어디서나 우린 함께해요.
어때요? 나랑 콜라보 하실래요?
당신의 KT.
메이플 스토리 2 신규 직업 스트라이커.
이거 좋은데?
답답할 때 마셔봐요 트로피카나 상큼상큼 과일 듬뿍 스파클링
리얼 프루트를 스파클링으로
과즙이 톡톡 쏜다 트로피카나 스파클링
대신적 혁신 이런 실시간 라이브 움짤 기능은 지금 스노우웹에서밖에 없죠. 굉장히 많은 팬분들이 영상 메시지와 메신저를 보내주고 계십니다. 아프리카 원탑 역캠답게 이설이라고 메시지가 왔는데 길 가다 만나지 마라. 길 가다 만나지 마라고. 느낌 있죠? 리본 하나 찬 다음에 딸랑딸랑 고양이. 섹시합니다. 외쳐 스노우! 라마?
스타일? 상쾌하면 되는 거야. 상쾌함의 높이가 다르다.
Stylish Sparkling Water. 롯데 트레비.
네, 아프리카 TV와 함께하는 킹덤 스토리 연애의 신.
이거 사극을 찍는 것 같아요.
정말 안 어울립니다.
아, 유비 느낌
약간 왜소하고.
위초고 삼국 대결.
장비! 나이스! 나이스!
나 심쿵했어.
17,800.
와!
군주는 무릎을 꿇을 수 있어요.
아, 뭐야 이거 어떻게 본 건데?
저에게는 간호 장비 같은 존재입니다.
진짜 유익한 게임이니까 여러분들 진짜로 많이 해보셨으면 좋겠습니다.
모바일 게임을 넘어선 액션 RPG 히트.
양 팀이 이제 정해졌는데
그냥 대결을 하면 좀 재미가 없으니까요.
탈락.
이전을 향해 쐈어요.
에이 큐피트.
에이 큐피트야 뭐가.
이 정도라면 4분 때에 마무리 되나요? 자 이거 3대 1 길 들어가는데요. 유저 전체에게 깃털 1000개를 선물로 드립니다.
타이밍이 지금인 것 같습니다.
이만한 게임이 지금 모바일 게임에는 없다고
생각합니다. 힘찬 행사.
오호, 물로 지금 거의 뭐 수분을 그냥 갖다 들이붓는 것 같아요. 자, 바른 쪽과 안 바른 쪽입니다. 차이 보여드릴게요. 내가 발라봤는데 대표는 앞으로 그냥 나도 찍어발라야 될 것 같아. 잘 봐요.
자, 이렇게
깔끔하게 아래쪽만 다듬어도 선이 딱 살아있잖아요. 선 라인 같아요.
잠깐만.
오, 이런 느낌이구나. 허허. 오늘 여러 가지 제품들 올리브영에서 제가 지금 제품을 받아서 사용을 해봤는데 굉장히 좋은 것 같아요. 올리브영 제품이 짱인 것 같습니다.
올리브영 플러스 유소나 예뻐져라 뷰티 방송. 홈쇼핑 아닙니다. 첫 뷰티 방송 시작하겠습니다. 달콤한 꽃에 겹겹이 둘러싸인 듯. 아, 여러분, 이 모든 제품들은 올리브영에서 살 수 있습니다. 새로운 네일 아트로 사랑을 표현할게요. 감사합니다. 고맙습니다. 세상에.
스타일? 상쾌하면 되는 거야. 상쾌함의 높이가 다르다.
Stylish Sparkling Water, Lotte Trevi.
나는 KT 기가 인터넷. 당신과 방송국을 만들죠. 어디서나 우린 함께해요.
어때요? 나랑 콜라보 하실래요?
당신의 KT.
우리 올리브영에서 드디어 루이저를 변화시키기 위해 우리 아프리카와 함께 루이저 변화시키기 대장정이 들어갔어요. 이게 스타일 업무 제품입니다. 어, 피부 밝아지는 것 같은데? 와, 이런 게 올리브영 클라스구나. 라마? 라마? 라마띠. 와우! 영국 스타일. 근데 멋있네. 나가면 번호 따일 것 같은데? 여기서 마무리할게요. 우리 제품은 올리브영 제품이었습니다.
미소가 생기다. 화사함이 생기다. 건강한 하루가 생기다. pH 8.0과 풍부한 미네랄로 핑크빛 생기가 생기다. 아이시스 8.0. 이제 모두 핑크하세요.
2016 Hot 6 GSL Season 2 Code S. Did someone say e-sports?
No.
Oh, my bad.
I said Code S.
Oh, my bad.
Which is the same thing! Woo!
We made it, guys. All right, we're going to go into, I think, what is easily going to be the best match of tonight. I'm so excited for this. SOS against TY. This could have been a finals, man.
Oh, well, this it could be a finals. It's like something we say when two great players play against each other, but I feel like we need something even more powerful than that.
Like, well, this is like a fan fiction moment, right?
Yeah.
Like, this is like, you know, when, like, someone tries to write a story that's going to be inspirational, but you're like, well, that would never happen in real life. Well, it's happening now.
Round of 32. We're in that group stage. Oh, this is going to be great. Guys, spread the word. TY versus SOS. Can't ask for a better match than this.
Who wins this? Who wins this? I think it's SOS.
I think TY wins it, actually.
All right.
Yeah, I do think TY wins. I think he might 2-0 even. But it could be a 2-1. But, look, King Sejong Station, I think that's a good map for TY. Dusk Towers, TY is fantastic on this map. And Frost can be a little bit hard as you get into the mid game against Terran. They can kind of be all over the place. So I'm kind of. And, you know, TY has just been better this year than SOS. So, yeah, no, I'm going with TY for this, Tasteless.
I don't know, man. SOS, he always pulls out these weird-ass builds. Like, I feel like even though SOS wins all the time, people still kind of doubt him.
Yeah,
and I feel that way because I was one of those guys where I'm like, no, I mean, I know he's good, but I think this guy's better.
Yeah.
But now I'm at the point where, you know...
The grass is always greener.
Throughout history, there's always that one Protoss guy that can kind of get away with anything. In Brood War, it was kind of like Nal Ra. He was that guy where I'm like, oh my god, you mean he can macro and he can cheese? Like he's one-time cheeses?
No.
Let's see, TY though, solid, sturdy Terran. Guys, this is a best of three. The winner is our first survivor of tonight's GSL, Code S.
Down here in the blue, our Protoss player.
Jhenair Greenwings, SOS.
Double thumbs up, as you said, Tasis.
Yeah. One. That's one thumb for each time you won the world championship. Maybe he doesn't have to get another arm. Maybe he has to get another thumb. We just, like, graft a thumb on him for his third world victory. In the upper left.
KT Rolster.
Just take a thumb off of you. Soon you're going to be thumbless.
Yeah, I'll be thumbless. I just basically have these, like, cat claws for hands. I'm trying to just... And that was when Tasis could only play games with a joystick.
You have to play very old arcade games or something. It's like he can only play Pac-Man. It's very, very sad.
Yeah.
But the thing is, he has to get his friends to put the quarters in for him. He can't do that himself. But I tell you, he's great at, if he can find someone to do that, he's great. He's great at Pac-Man.
Oh, God. It's like, well, where did his thumbs go? It's like, well, SOS won two more world champions, and by the transitive property of the graphic in season two of 2016, Tasis had to lose his thumbs. It's like,
yeah, it was very clear. So like, especially because he was tasteless, and we can use the less still if we take his thumbs. There's no thumb puns with Arctosis.
No.
There's no point to that whatsoever. But then I'm sure you become very passionate. You like a lot of old hard games. So.
I do. Yeah.
Like, tasteless, what do you... What do you think about Pac-Man versus Miss Pac-Man? Like, let me tell you, okay? That bow, that extra graphical load on the, you know, on Mrs. Pac-Man, and yeah.
And sadly, Tasis was never able to beat Battletoads because that required thumbs to use a controller. So.
Yeah, even though frogs don't have thumbs.
That's true. Maybe I am a Battletoad. All right, so. you look like a Battletoad.
Yeah, pretty much.
So, we got a proxied robo.
Yeah.
This is pretty cool. Now, this is what I was talking about. I was saying before the match started, what crazy-ass build is SOS going to do here? What stuff could he do that you just, you know, it's not going to be a normal game that TY is prepared for. And this is a proxy robo into expand, so this is not an all-in.
Yeah, this is not
this
like
this is like a pressure. Oh, my God.
No.
No way.
No,
okay,
he'd never go all the way down there. That's why. Oh, my God.
No. No.
Look at SOS's face.
He's like, all right, well.
His head just jerked a little bit, but no real emotion is being shown.
Okay, he's like, I guess I have to let this thing finish. All right, well, this is.
Well, the Reaper is going to have to sit there for a very long time to kill two pylons.
Yeah.
Eventually, it will get them. That's really annoying for him. And the fact that he's just, like, getting a. Like, I wonder if he was going to make.
Oh,
you know what? He's going to go Immortal Second.
Yeah.
Right? Or well, no, maybe not. No, he's warp gate's almost done. He can just warp in units. That's fine.
Yeah.
So this is just going to be
you know what happened. You know what happened is we casted StarCraft 1 yesterday, so we're forgetting about warp in here. We're like, oh no, that's right. He's actually fine. By the way, guys, we were there's a sister tournament to this one, the ASL. It's only gone on for 2 days. Mm-hmm. We're casting Brood War. It's sick. Know your roots.
I wonder, because StarCraft 1 is an older game, but GSL is an older tournament. Is it, you call it a sister game, is it younger sister? You know what I think it is? I think it's an older sister that's been in a coma for 10 years.
Ah, okay, so she comes back
she's
to life.
Frail,
she's frail,
she
younger.
Can't quite walk yet.
Yeah.
You know,
but she's going to learn. She's going to come out of that coma.
iPhones exist. She's like, what's this?
Yeah. I like that. I like what you just said.
She watches the Ninja Turtles movies. Like, what the hell happened to my childhood?
Who's Michael Bay and why did he ruin my favorite cartoon? Yeah, no, I totally get it. We have the Observer coming in here now. Kind of a funny situation to have that robo spotted. It's always interesting to see a game where the proxy's spotted, but it's not stopped.
Yeah.
It's kind of a weird,
well,
funny
looking. He called the bluff of the Reaper. Now the Reaper, you know, the Reaper isn't going to be able to scout him at all, and he does force it away, going into disruptor drops. This is really funny, because that's so far out of a position where it's easy for TY to attack.
Yeah, it's actually very well placed. Okay, so let's see how much damage this can do.
Yeah, that was great. Oh, my God! Oh, that was like a millisecond before that thing shot.
That was
crazy. Oh, my God. Oh. Oh, you know, breathe with me, guys. Oh, my God. Oh.
This is what's so...
Tosis loses that prism every time. Every time.
You remember this joke? I think it was when we were in France casting for DreamHack. And I think Todd actually told me that you said this. He thought it was so funny. Oh, my God. Nice hit there. Beautiful. Is that, you know, you'll be, like, playing a game, and you have, like, this one Phoenix that's, like, in the red in your group. And you're like, well, I better send that out. It's got some energy. I can pick stuff up. And then you send it out, and you always lose it.
Oh, yeah. No.
You cast more than you play now. So.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. You know, this style of play is based off of Reaver drops in StarCraft 1, but the thing with a Reaver is that you can pick it up after the Reaver fires, you can pick it up and move.
Ooh.
Look at this.
A little depth move coming in here. Plenty of Marines, so it's not really going to do any damage, but... Yeah, this is, it's pretty cool. Look at this. He's going to try to use Disruptors to get rid of the Siege Tank.
Oh, my God. Oh, my, oh no, God, it hit it. Anyways.
Okay, going to try to chase this away. We'll be, oh, he's going to chase this down.
What
this is so
is
sick.
This
look at this, Michael.
Game?
Oh, man. Going to pick up these Stalkers. Can't quite chase that down. Great
that
micro
there. That was actually
there.
Crazy, man. They were both playing that so
yeah,
well.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Well, this is why this